The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The Reverend Cecil Greenridge is with us today to give us the invocation. He is pastor from Emmanuel Pentecostal Church in Brooklyn, New York. Reverend?
Shall we pray? Eternal and most gracious and ever-loving Father, we thank you this hour and time for life. And we thank you for bringing us here safely and for this gathering. But I pray, God, even now that you will touch life. As I lift up this house before you, mighty God, and every representative, I pray, God, that you will bring forth, God, the vision, oh dear God, of your people, that even if you, mighty God, lay across the table, you will bring resolution. Oh, Father and God, touch the life of your people with wisdom, with knowledge, and with understanding, that at the end of this, almighty God, the dream of the state of New York shall become a reality, and men and women, mighty God, shall rejoice and be glad in you and in your salvation. We thank you even now for what you're going to do in the life of your people, and we bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend. The reading of the journal.
In Senate, Sunday, May 15th, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Saturday, May 14th is read and approved. On motion, Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Secretary Reed.
On page 39, Senator Avello moved to discharge to the Committee on Elections Assembly Bill Number 7817 and substituted the identical Senate Bill 6818, third reading calendar 729.
So ordered. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees. Communications and reports from state officers. Motions and resolutions. Senator DeFran.
Madam President, I request that the following bills be discharged from their respective committees and be recommitted with instructions to strike the enacting clause. All by Senator Flanagan, Senate numbers 4216, 4217, 4218.
So ordered.
I also move that the following bill by Senator LaValle, Senate Print 7576, be discharged from its respective committee and be recommitted with instructions to strike the enacting clause.
So ordered.
I now wish to call up Senator LaValle's bill number 2926, recall from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary Reed.
Calendar number 169 by Senator LaValle, Senate Print 2926, an act in relation to authorizing.
I now move to reconsider the vote by which this bill was passed.
Call the roll on reconsideration.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young, ayes 55.
Madam President, I now offer the following amendments.
The bill is restored to its place on the third reading calendar.
Next, I wish to call up Senator LaValle's bill print 2928, recall from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary Reed.
Go ahead.
Secretary Reed.
Calendar number 170 by Senator LaValle, Senate Print 2928, an act in relation to authorizing.
I now move to reconsider the vote by which the bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young, ayes 55.
I see. The bill is restored in its place on the third reading calendar.
I now offer the following amendments.
Amendments received and the bill retains its place on the third reading calendar.
Next, I wish to call up Senator Croce's bill number 3137B, recall from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary Reed.
Calendar number 360 by Senator Croce, Senate Print 3137B, an act amend the executive law.
I now move to reconsider the vote by which this bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young, ayes 55.
I now offer the following amendments.
The bill is restored on its third reading calendar. Amendments are received, and the bill retains its place on the third reading calendar.
Madam President, I now on page 17, I offer the following amendments to Senator Marcelino's bill, calendar 225, Senate print 5795, and ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
So ordered.
Madam President, on page 19, I offer the following amendments to Senator Ritchie's bill, calendar 270, Senate print 6756, and ask that said bill retain its place on third reading.
So ordered.
On page 32, I offer the following amendments to Senator Reinzenhofer's bill, calendar 637, Senate print 6322, and ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
So ordered.
And on the following motion is on page 37, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 746, Senator Ritchie's bill, print 6222B, and ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
So ordered.
To who first? Madam President, can we now take up previously adopted resolution number 5144 by Senator Amador, read the title only, and call on Senator Amador.
Secretary Reed.
Legislative resolution number 5144 by Senator Amador, memorializing Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 15 to May 21, 2016 as Prevention Week in New York State in conjunction with the observance of National Prevention Week.
Senator Amador.
Madam President, this week is National Prevention Week, a time for communities to come together to increase awareness about substance abuse, problems gambling, mental health issues. Addiction comes in many shapes, but in one form of another or another, it touches everyone in every community throughout the state of New York. Here in New York, we are doing everything possible we need to do to tackle the issue of addiction, including the addiction of heroin and the crisis that we see throughout the state of New York with this. We are doing everything we can to make sure that treatment and recovery services and options are available to those who need them the most, and the proper support systems are in place to help those at risk so they won't relapse. Of course, prevention and awareness are efforts that always are key to eradicating any addiction problem. So today we have on the Senate chamber floor some of the great organizations who are helping throughout all of our communities in the prevention efforts. Today we have with us from New York City the Prevention Resource Center. We have BOCES Educational Support Services. We have Schenectady County Substance Abuse Prevention Coalition. We have Hamilton Fulton Montgomery Prevention Council, and we have OASAS. Some of these groups are doing an outstanding job, or all of these groups are doing an outstanding job, and there's so many others throughout the state. But I don't think that the Senate floor would have been able to hold them all. But if you could all rise so we can see who you are, and we could congratulate your strong effort, your tireless work, and your passion and love to help those throughout our communities in great need. You know, this year the theme for National Prevention Week is Strong as One, Stronger Together. We all know one person can make a difference in our community, but when we all work together in one common purpose, we can achieve so much more. So thank you so much for all that you have already achieved, and the vision and the love and the goals that you have to help all of our constituents who struggle with addiction and that hopefully prevent them forever being bound by it. Thank you all.
Mr. Floor Leader?
Yes. Could we please open that resolution up for co-sponsorship?
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
Madam President, can we now introduce Senator Martins for an introduction of some very important people?
Senator Martins.
Thank you, Madam President. It's my honor to present our Cadet Squadron 288 from Nassau and Suffolk Counties, members who are here with us today in the gallery. The Civil Air Patrol serves an enormously important function. They were formed right at the beginning of World War II, and through that period to today, they account for 90% of all the inland searches that exist in our country. An average of 75 people are saved per year as a result of the Civil Air Patrol's efforts. But most importantly, Madam President, I ask you to look up into the gallery and look at the young men and women who are here with us today and understand that these are kids who are in high school. These are volunteers who are not only working and go along with these Civil Air Patrols as they patrol the areas in the coasts of Long Island and areas of New York State, but they're actively involved in their local communities. They work hard, they participate, and at a time when we have so few who volunteer for anything, how great is it to have a group of young men and women who not only care, but care enough to volunteer and to give of themselves to help others in an organized way? So we have members who came up today. They've had the opportunity to tour the Capitol, to meet with many of our members. But it is a proud moment for us, certainly for me and for my colleagues from Long Island and throughout New York State, to recognize these young men, to thank them for being here. And in particular, I want to take the opportunity to recognize two of these members who are from my district. I have Cadet Master Sergeant David Giannitelli and Cadet Master Sergeant Matthew Erline, who are both here. Gentlemen, thank you very much for being here. Godspeed. You give us hope that there are people who are going to put the best interest of our communities and the country first and foremost as we go forward. Thanks for joining us today. Madam President, thank you for the opportunity. And I know that I have my colleagues here from Long Island who would likewise like to recognize members from their communities as well. Thank you.
Venditto.
Of course, and welcoming the members of the Civil Air Patrol who are joining us today, and thank them for their service, for their commitment, for all that they are putting into what they do. You know, we're always looking for a bright spark to associate with our future, and getting to meet all of you and feel and see that potential that you have inside, I think we can all agree that the future of our country is looking much brighter thanks to the work that that you are doing. You make us all proud to be Americans. You certainly make people like me proud to be elected officials and preside over the communities which I do. So again, thank you. Thank you all for being with us today. I'd be honored to recognize actually seven of the members of the Civil Air Patrol who are joining us from the 8th Senatorial District. We have Jared Del Orfano for Merrick, Ricardo Gomez Nieto from Belmore, Esther Sherry from Farmingdale, Brendan Handima from Belmore, Jacqueline Rathjen from Massapequa, Michael Pinna from Farmingdale, and Mark Del Orfano from Merrick. Once again, welcome to the chamber today. Thank you for the work that you're doing. May God continue to bless you in that work and the greatest, most beautiful country in the world, the United States of America. Thank you, Madam President.
Mr. Floor Leader.
Could you please call on Senator Amador to introduce another group of fine people?
Senator Amador.
To introduce in the chamber up in the gallery a group of students that is visiting. They drove up from Kingston, New York today, and they are a group of students ranging at an age of around 10 to 15 years old, and they are all homeschooled students who this past year have been learning all about civics. And they're here today to learn about what's going on, what we do in state government, and to get a tour of this great building and to see all of us. And so congratulations for your field trip coming up. And we've spent some time talking about some of their vision and goals that they have in life. And I commend all of you never to give up. And I hope the very best for you, because I know your future is very bright. Thank you.
Mr. Floor Leader.
Yes, thank you. I believe we've handed up some committee assignments.
It's a receipt when we filed with the journal.
And where's the Rules Committee meeting? 332?
Madam President, I'd like to call an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332. Immediate meeting of Rules 332.
Immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332 of the Capitol. The Senate will stand at ease.
And we will return very shortly if everyone leaves now. Thank you. Has the Rules Committee report been presented to the desk yet?
Is it? Yes, it has.
Would you please return to that report and move to accept that report?
Secretary O'Reed.
Senator Flanagan from the Committee on Rules reports the following bills. Senate Print 631 by Senator Carlucci, enact amend the mental hygiene law. Senate 2346 by Senator Sewer, enact amend the tax law. Senate 2484A by Senator Giannaris, enact amend the penal law. Senate 2641 by Senator Savino, enact amend the penal law. Senate 2787 by Senator Parker, enact amend the public health law. Senate 3458B by Senator Carlucci, enact to direct. Senate 3666 by Senator Savino, enact amend the penal law. Senate 3805 by Senator Parker, enact amend the domestic relations law. Senate 5478 by Senator Griffo, enact amend Chapter 19 of the laws of 2014. Senate 5506A by Senator Savino, enact amend the personal property law. Senate 5546A by Senator Funke, enact amend the education law. Senate 6248B by Senator Ort, enact amend the mental hygiene law. Senate 6317 by Senator DeFrancisco, enact amend the criminal procedure law. Senate 6632A by Senator Croce, enact amend the public health law. Senate 6719 by Senator Murphy, enact amend the public health law. Senate 6962A by Senator Hannan, enact amend the insurance law. Senate 7012 by Senator Ort, enact amend the penal law. Senate 7187 by Senator Young, enact amend Chapter 142 of the laws of 2014. Senate 7200 by Senator Akshar, enact amend the penal law. Senate 7315 by Senator Murphy, enact amend the mental hygiene law. Senate 7317A by Senator Murphy, enact amend the social services law. Senate 7365 by Senator Akshar, enact amend the public health law. Senate 7397 by Senator Murphy, enact amend the public health law. Senate 7446 by Senator Amador, enact amend the mental hygiene law. And Senate 7748A by Senator Carlucci, enact amend the mental hygiene law. All bills reported direct to third reading.
Mr. Floor Leader.
Move to accept the report of the Rules Committee.
All in favor of accepting the report of the Rules Committee, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The report is accepted. Mr. Floor Leader.
Could we please return to motions and resolutions and take up the previously adopted resolution by Senator Hannan, number 3831. Read the title only and call on Senator Hannan.
The Secretary will read.
Legislative Resolution number 3831 by Senator Hannan, memorializing Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 2016 as Stroke Awareness Month in the state of New York.
Senator Hannan.
President,
Today we just wanted to note that Stroke Awareness Month is this month, the month of May. Stroke awareness is the fifth cause of death in the United States, with killing over 129,000 people each year. We're visited today by members of the lobbying group for the American Heart Association, including Bob Elling, who's chair of their advocacy committee and an EMS advocate for years, lives here in the Albany area, and along with Dr. Colm Amery from the Albany Medical Center, who told us of some exciting new procedures that are literally 30 times more efficient in saving people's lives and actually curing them of the defects of stroke. So that what we're trying to do is get some awareness for a bill that Senator Murphy is carrying in this House that would lead to that adoption and improvement on a voluntary basis and help save lives. And so we just wanted to thank the people who are advocating for this today. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Mr. Floor Leader.
Would you please open this resolution for co-sponsorship?
Resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to co-sponsor, you should notify the desk.
Thank you. Can we now take up Senator Bonasek's resolution 490-7. Read the title only and call on Senator Bonasek.
Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 4907 by Senator Bonasek, memorializing Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 15 to 17, 2016 as the 81st annual 4-H Capital Days in the state of New York.
Senator Bonasek.
Thank you, Mr. President. Today to report that I had plenty of young farmers in training visiting with me from Orange County, Sullivan County, Delaware County, and Ulster County. And, you know, we're all striving to keep the agricultural industry strong and alive in spite of what our governor's been doing. And I asked them, do you have an interest in going into farming? Because what we're hearing is many of the younger generation wants to do something else because it's so difficult, farming. And when we look at our agricultural industry, for every farmer that's over 75 years of age, there's one farmer under 30 years of age. So we know we want to have more farmers. So I asked them, are you interested in staying in farming? And I was surprised. The majority of them said yes. And in the 4-H, they learn about the care of animals. They learn responsibility. They learn a work ethic. They learn for respect of the land. And as a result, this resolution is statewide for all 4-H youth that are in our districts throughout the state. I'm here to welcome them and thank them very much for all that they do within the 4-H community. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Bonasek. Mr. Floor Leader.
Could we please open that resolution up for co-sponsorship?
Resolution is open to co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
Can you please now call on Senator Hamilton to introduce a group of members from the Asian Civil Observation Patrol?
Senator Hamilton.
President, I rise with pleasure today to introduce a group of volunteers from the 20th Senatorial District in Kings County, God's Country, which is one of the most premier patrol groups in Brooklyn. And it's the Brooklyn Asian Civilian Observation Patrol. And they do this patrol out of the goodness of their heart. They don't get paid to do this. They have long hours in the community, and they have tours from 7 p.m. to 4 a.m. in the morning. We have one of the largest growing immigrant populations from China in our district, and they are the link between the police department and the Asian community. And I want to thank all my brothers up there, Ni Hamao, Hao, and to Captain Louis Liu for doing a phenomenal job in the community. Every time we have an event, They're always there in the park. They're always there on the street. And they patrol the street, and they don't have guns, but they apprehend criminals. And they have one of the quickest response times of any local civilian patrol. Within 1 minute? No, 1 hour. No, 1 minute, sorry. 1 minute of them making a call to the precincts. But they actually work with five precincts in Brooklyn. And within a minute of them making a telephone call, they have coordinated and synchronize with the NYPD to apprehend people. So I just commend them for putting their lives on the line to protect us, to keep us safe, and for doing a great job. And we just want to congratulate you on keep doing the hard work that you're doing in the community, and we thank you for that. Xie xie.
Thank you, Senator Hamilton. Mr. Floor Leader?
Would you now take up the non-controversial reading of the calendar? We're not going to do the rules bills.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 62 by Senator Addabbo, Senate Print 4233C, enacting amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 1st of July.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 226 by Senator Marcelino, Senate Print 6514, enacting amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 301 by Senator Klein, Senate Print 1356, enacting amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 6, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Relation to calendar 301, those recorded in the negative are Senators Comrie, Hamilton, Hassel-Thompson, Hoylman, Krueger, Perkins, Persaud, Rivera, Sanders, and Squadron. Ayes 49, nays 10.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 372 by Senator Comrie, Senate Print 4945, enact amend the agriculture markets law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 378 by Senator Marcelino, Senate Print 422, an act to amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the results.
Relation to calendar 378, those recorded in the negative, are Senators Comrie, DeLon, Gianars, Hamilton, Hoylman, Krueger, Parker, Peralta, Perkins, Persaud, Rivera, Serrano, and Squadron. Ayes 46, nays 13.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 427 by Senator Griffel, Senate Print 2720, enact amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Relation to calendar 427, those recorded in the negative are Senators Comrie, DeLon, Hassel-Thompson, Hoylman, Krueger, Parker, Perkins, Persaud, Rivera, Sanders, Serrano, Squadron, also Senator Montgomery, also Senator Peralta. Ayes 45, nays 14.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 442 by Senator Little, Senate Print 6088A, enact amend the corrections law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 58, nays 1. Senator Comrie recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 443 by Senator Farley, Senate Print 6849, enact amend the corrections law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 58.
Announce the result.
Ayes 57, nays 2. Senators Comrie and Montgomery recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 472 by Senator Lavalle, Senate Print 2099, enact amend the criminal procedure law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Relation to calendar 472, those recorded in the negative are Senators Comrie, DeLon, Krueger, Montgomery, Perkins, and Rivera. Also Senator Hoylman. Ayes 52, nays 7.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 478 by Senator Ritchie, Senate Print 3104, enact amend the criminal procedure law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Relation to calendar 478, those recorded in the negative are Senators DeLon, Hoylman, Krueger, Perkins, and Squadron. Also Senator Comrie. Ayes 53, nays 6.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 527 by Senator Martin, Senate Print 4879C, enacted in relation to permitting.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 58, nays 1. Senator Larkin recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 585 by Senator Lanza, Senate Print 3316A, enacted amend the tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 1st of April.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Relation to calendar 585. Those recorded in the negative are Senators DeLon, Hamilton, Hoylman, Krueger, Parker, Perkins, Sanders, and Squadron. Also Senator Montgomery. Ayes 50, nays 9.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 604 by Senator Venditto, Senate Print 4778A, enacted amend the general business law.
Read the last section. Bill is laid aside for the day.
Calendar number 634 by Senator Romero, Senate Print 7197, Act amending the Environmental Conservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Senator Lavelle.
Vote. Within the last 10 months or so, had the opportunity of meeting with the fishermen, commercial fishermen, out off of Dune Road. And one of the things that we talked about is the reports that the DEC request our fishermen to fill out. And I was also informed that this information that is supposed to help the DEC set size limitations, those are put into a box, what the fishermen fill out, put in a box, and those boxes are put down in a basement or a storehouse without anyone looking at them. As many of you know, over the years, I have voted no on these bills dealing with fish because it affects the commercial fishermen. And it should be based on something, on some science, on some statistics. And at this meeting, I was like, my feet weren't on the ground, and I said, I knew I was right in voting no on those bills, because it was based on nothing but someone just saying, well, I think, you know, it should be this size or that size. And so, Senator O'Mara, I just am not voting no for to be indifferent or contrary, but I'm basing it now on the evidence I had with the meeting of my commercial fishermen. So I vote both no on this bill and the next one. Mr. President, I vote no.
Senator Lavelle, you'd be recorded in the negative. Announce the results.
Ayes 58, nays 1.
Bill is passed.
Excuse me. Votes recorded in the negative on calendar 634. Our Senators Hassel Thompson and Lavelle. Ayes 57, nays 2.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 635 by Senator O'Mara, Senate Print 7222, enact amend Chapter 305 of the laws of 2013.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 58, nays 1. Senator Lavelle recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 676 by Senator Golden, Senate Print 783, enact amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 687 by Senator Young, Senate Print 3013, enact amend the tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Relation to calendar 687, those recorded in the negative are Senators Comrie, DeLon, Gianaris, Hassel Thompson, Hoylman, Krueger, Montgomery, Parker, Perkins, Rivera, Serrano, and Squadron. Ayes 47, nays 12.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 701 by Senator Lanza, Senate Print 7109, enactment in Chapter 890 of the laws of 1982.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 704 by Senator Lanza, Senate Print 7332, enact amend Chapter 306 of the laws of 2011.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce
Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 711 by Senator Robach, Senate Print 1963, enact amend the corrections law.
Bill is laid aside.
Calendar number 717 by Senator Young, Senate Print 6259, enact amend the real property actions.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the result.
Ayes 58, nays 1. Senator Perkins recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 718 by Senator Lanza, Senate Print 2544, enact amend the not-for-profit corporation law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 719 by Senator Lanza, Senate Print 3391. Enact amend Chapter 47 of the laws of 1931.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect upon the enactment into law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 729 by Member of the Assembly Kuzik, Assembly Print 7817. Enact amend the elections law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 730 by Senator Savino, Senate Print 6833A, enact amend the elections law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 57, nays 2, Senators Croce and DeFrancisco recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 739 by Senator Gallivan, Senate Print 6309, an act to authorize.
There's a home rule message at the desk. The secretary will read.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Read the last section.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59.
Bill is passed. Mr. Floor Leader, that completes the non-controversial reading of the calendar.
Would you please take up the controversial reading?
Secretary will ring the bell. Secretary will read.
Calendar number 711 by Senator Robach, Senate Print 1963, enact amend the corrections law.
Senator Sanders.
President, will the sponsor yield to a question?
Yield to a question?
Oh. It's common knowledge that good time credit in prison reduces infractions in prison, therefore reduces violence, and that some of the major people who are behind good time are actually the prison unions. I'm trying to find why this bill, why would we get rid of or hurt that system which is helping to reduce the violence in prison? Some have said, of course, that it has to do with keeping bodies in prison so that the prisons so that they can keep jobs. Mm-hmm. I refuse to believe that that's the reason for this. I there must be some more, so I'm asking the sponsor if he was would give me a reason for this. Thank you, Mr. President.
Absolutely, Senator Sanders, and good question. You are right in your remarks. This has nothing to do with employment, but really has come from several high-profile cases directly in Monroe County, but we know what's going on all across the state. where we do think time should be off from good behavior, but it should start at 100% of your time and live up to what the Department of Corrections says, which is that just for violent felons, that every violent felon, and I quote right from DOCS's press release, does 80% of their time 100% of the time. That is absolutely a falsehood. We have had very violent predicate felons released into my community 60%, 50% of their time, who have gone out and killed and re-victimized more people. And these are the most violent of violent offenders. So while I'd like them to be eligible for some good time, I believe is a statement of criminal justice to stop more recidivism, to make less victims, as well as be fair to those families and those that have already been victimized. These people should be doing 80% of their time, which ironically is what people in state government who run these facilities are saying they're doing now, but we know from activities, murders, additional rapes, that's actually not being utilized while it's being talked about. This bill would put into statute what they're saying they're doing by their own words and actions, and I think this would be a very good bill. This is not about whether jail is good or bad. This is the most violent people, and should they serve 80% of their sentence, which has been suggested, will that lead to more incarceration? It will, but what it will lead to more is a fairer system and less people being victimized. This isn't Rockefeller drug laws. This isn't nonviolent felons. This is violent felons, oftentimes predicate felons. And I don't want to give you too lengthy of an answer. I would have liked to make this bill even bigger. One case in Rochester where they had already previous shooter got stopped. They didn't revoke his parole. 6 days later, he shot six people, one who which died, which wasn't the person he was trying to kill, in a very nice establishment where people were there, most of them, to listen to music, have a good time, and relax. So the purpose of this really is to balance the scales of justice back to a little bit more fairness for our most violent. And again, I think there's so much frustration from victims' rights groups, people at every level of government, because they keep being told that we're imagining this because, again, it's being told to them that 80% of the time, or 100% of the time, 80% of the time is being done for violent felons. Just not the case. We want to put it in the statute so there can be a little iron in the words they're saying, and that really can occur.
Sir, yield for a question. Senator Robach, you continue to yield?
I will.
Has the sponsor done any type of study on everything we do has a positive and a negative? Have you weighed to see getting rid of good time? Will that do more damage than this? I agree with you. Some of these crimes are horrendous, and we need to do something about it.
This would simply say, I haven't done any research other than to work with the community, victims, and pay attention to what's going on. All this says is good time won't start till 80% of the time. I could tell you what research I've done is, people don't care how good people are in jail or what model inmate they are when they're let out at 50% of their sentence after they've already killed one person and now kill a number of others. The only way I could say it, Senator Sanders, is this. No one knows what somebody's gonna do the first time, regardless of what the motivation is. But as a system, we do have to take some responsibility for what we do the second time. And I would even go further to say, in my book, in my estimation, I even think many of the sentences these people get, considering the havoc they've wreaked on families, communities, sometimes whole neighborhoods, I think their sentences are too short to begin with. But then to compound that and let them out at half the time and let good behavior or other things kick in, I almost think it's the opposite. I think that there's a little quota going on that we're letting out some violent people for the first time, so we can let a certain amount of people out to save money at the expense of public safety, and I think that's a bad mistake. So again, this really would say, not take away any of the things you're talking about, but say for our most violent predicate felons, that won't kick in until they've served 80% of the time before they can become eligible for those programs. And we've done bills like this before. We've had some inmates who are in life for multiple life sentences in a family reunification program. Why spend the tax dollars? Why do that when they're never getting out? To me, this is just another one of those. The punishment has to fit the crime, but more importantly, it's our job, second time around, to make sure we can say to the public, we're trying to strike that right balance and make sure no one gets victimized again to the best of our ability.
Mr. President, I believe that the sponsor's ideas are quite fitting in one sense. I share the
Are you on the bill, Senator Sanders?
Say again.
On the bill?
On the bill, I'm sorry, on the bill. I share the outrage of the sponsor on many of these points. However, I think that we're going to make the prison guard situation even more dangerous. Good time is one of their main inducements that they use to make sure that people behave themselves in prison. I think that that, and while we may stop one or two, I think that we're making it more dangerous for hundreds more. So under those conditions, I'm going to vote no on this one, sir. Thank you, Mr. President.
And Senator Sanders recorded in the negative. Are there any other members wishing to be heard? Seeing none, the debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bell. Call the roll.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately. Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Yes. Senator Montgomery.
I want to explain my vote. I will be voting no on this bill. And I just want to remind Senator Robach that there is already in place a major rationale for keeping people in prison far beyond the time that they would ordinarily be eligible for parole, and that is the use of the excuse of instant offense. So your bill just adds one more layer to that issue and denies people who would otherwise be eligible for parole. And I also want to just remind my colleagues that the fact of the matter is most of the people who are admitted into prison, who come into prison in any given year right now, are people who violated technical parole issues. They did not commit new crimes. So we have now created in our state a problem with recidivism that is not related to new crimes, but is related to people who are returned to prison because of so-called technical violations. That is the statistics that comes from Department of Corrections themselves. So I am going to vote no on this legislation because I do not believe it addresses the issue that you may be trying to talk about, using instances outside of the prison to come up with an excuse for denying people, one more excuse for denying people parole when they should actually ordinarily be eligible for it. So I vote no, Mr. President.
Senator Montgomery to be recorded in the negative. Announce the result.
Relation to calendar 711, those recorded in the negative are Senators Comrie, DeLon, Gianaris, Hamilton, Hassel-Thompson, Hoylman, Krueger, Montgomery, Parker, Perkins, Rivera, Sanders, Squadron, and Stavisky. Absent from voting, Senators Espaillat, Larkin, Marchione, Panapinto, and Savino. Ayes 40, nays 14.
The bill is passed. Floor Leader, that completes the controversial reading of the calendar.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is not.
There being none, I move to adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, May 17th at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, May 17th at 3 p.m.